Hi, thanks for coming, guys. We're going to do everything in English. I've agreed that with the local journalists. If you do need anything translated, just say, and we have a translator on hand. Start us off, Richard.
I hope. Of course, Wayne spoke to me about this and that he had a talk to the national coach and he made his decision because he thinks he's the best for Everton. And there's always the decision by the player, and of course I respect that. And that's what came out this morning.
Well, at Wayne's age, were you ever concerned if he did go and play for England again, it might impact on his
No, of course, if we reach the group stage of the Europa League, then and international duty, that's really a tough program. But he's on really good fitness at the moment, and it's always up to the player, the feeling of the player, what he think what's the best to do. And I respect that. I respect if he make a different decision about his future as English national player, but I think it's a good decision for him, and it's a good decision for Everton, because that means that in international duty you will have some days off for the family.
In your own
place,
Robin, did you carry on playing for 2 or 3 years after you finished the tournament? Did you feel the benefits of that if you were playing on?
Yeah, but you can't compare every situation, every decision. It's all about your feeling, and it's also about when you need to stop football. It's one is stopping by 32, other is stopping by 36, and like Gerrit Berry likes to move on his age to play still every weekend football. And I think your body is the main reason to say stop for football, and and then finally it's always this decision by the player. I don't know, that's the question for Wayne. I think what he did for the national team was good enough. There's a time to come and a time to go, and he made that decision. I don't give Wayne advice because I'm not the right person in his decision. And the same, if he like to continue playing for the national team, can be a good decision. It's because he's still on that fitness that he can deal with a tough program, that he can deal with national team football and football for Everton. No, I think if you go in on the pitch with a defensively attitude to keep the result, defending, no, it's our way to play is to control the game, to score goals. Of course, we have a good advantage, but it's still 90, 95 minutes to play. We know it will be difficult. It's a tough week after last Monday, City. We travel today, but okay, we will be strong tomorrow. We need to be strong tomorrow to get in the group stage.
Is it going to be possible to challenge top four in Premier League?
now it's difficult to give competition to the strongest team in the Premier League with or without European football. We know European football makes it even tougher, but that's what we like to have. It's no reason to play different or to prepare different for tomorrow. That's, I think Everton, with the history of the club, is important to be part of Europe. But we know it's even more difficult. But okay, we have enough players. Of course, we have some injuries, and that makes it tough this week. But okay, we will fight and we will do the maximum to get in Europe. No, but I think it's normal. It's the ambition of the club. It's the ambition of the manager. It's the ambition of the players that they like to be part of Europe, because you like to play European football. I'm watching European football for the last 3 years, and that's really nice. The Tuesday, the Wednesday, the Thursday, but you like to be involved. For us now in the Thursday, and of course that makes it difficult, because Sunday 1:30 we get the next whistle by the referee against Chelsea, but we prepare the game and we go one by one and we do the maximum to get the best result out of every single game. Yeah, maybe, yes. Maybe they don't care enough for European football. I was totally agreed to Jose about last season what happened to Man United. The same is now in this week. But we know the television, the money decide a lot. And that's even more difficult to play tomorrow night here. And we played on last Monday. Not the Saturday or not the weekend, the Sunday, sorry. Saturday wasn't possible, but the Sunday, yes, but it's the commercial side of football, and that makes it even more difficult.
Well, so you got injuries, Sandro traveled?
No, Sandro is not traveling. David Klaassen is not traveling. And then knock on his feet, will be out for, I think, for at least 1 week, but he will be fit after the international break, and Sandro will be a doubt for Sunday.
Just over a week, sort of the deadline today. Are
you any close to striking the middle? No, we're working on that. We know we have still 10 days to go, but it's not more update about that today.
Last week,
I don't hope that it happened again tomorrow night. I think it's we know about the fans of Hajduk. They will support the team. They will try to intimidate Everton, but they are not very close to the pitch. It's on the stands, and that's no problem, because that's really atmosphere what you like to play football. And we have enough experienced players that can deal with that kind of ambience. No. Yeah, but okay, it's always difficult to knock on his knee, and I think it's normally after the international duty here, I think he will be a fail. Yeah, but I don't know this. I think he made his decision clear this morning, and okay, I think I'm already responding a lot of questions about that. Leave it and please questions about tomorrow.
You go tomorrow with a full squad or you will rest some players? What is your game plan?
My game plan is to win the game. At least to qualify for the group stage. We know we had a difficult, tough match last Monday. But the lineup will be very strong. And you know we have competition, you can change players, but the lineup will be a strong one. And of course, if there is any player who's not 100% fit, then he will not start. But I expect everybody available for tomorrow. Now the decision I need to make. He got his game time last Monday. The decision is, or he will start tomorrow, or he come in the game during the game. We have one training now, and that decision will be made tomorrow morning.
Couple of words about Kaidu, about your adversary tomorrow.
Sorry, about
couple of words about the home team, Kaidu.
Now we know they can be strong. I think we had a really good first 45 minutes against Hajduk at home. I think they did well in the second half. About two reasons. They did the job better than they did it in the first half. We dropped the intensity in the game in the second half. They had some two, three good chances to score one goal. And okay, it's really a good result, but you're halfway. Another game to play tomorrow night, and it will be tough.
Okay, what did you learn for the first match in Liverpool? Because you were dangerous in the first half, but then in the other half you were completely different.
Yeah,
that's how you could give you easily one goal. It looked like that.
No,
if
I don't.
You didn't have such a great goalkeeper.
Yeah, but okay, we know we did a good first half, and but it's always normal if you are 2-0 up in half time that the opponent react. That's normal. I think it's a good result for tomorrow to start, but we know they have qualities, they create some good chances, they have some players back, some good young players, and okay, we need to be at our best tomorrow to get in the group stage of the Europa League.
Hey guys, any more questions?
I don't know, it's all about the game. And I don't speak about losing games. I think more about winning games. No, I mean, it's every player can be a question for Thursday, but I think the fitness level of the players is really good. Still in the beginning of the season, and it's not my job to make a. It's not my. I need to say that it's. I'm not. Of course, in some position we can do rotations, but I believe more in a group of players when we are doing well, and that means that I will not change a lot.
Okay, guys, thanks very much.